Hello friends, today we are going to discuss important questions from the topic credit trading agencies. So credit trading agencies, they are an important intermediary in the securities market. So it is an important topic for our SEBI grade examination. So friends, if you like this video, then do subscribe to our channel. So let's begin. So first of all, we will log into our website anujindal.in. Then I'll go to this link. So here you can see there is a quizzes section. So in this section, I'll go to SEBI grade A. So here you can notice that quizzes are available for different examinations like RBI grade B, SEBI grade A, UGC NET, NABARD grade A. So you can attempt these quizzes and get the benefit. So here I'll go to SEBI grade A. So here you can see quizzes are available for different topics for a SEBI grade examination. So today we are going to discuss important questions on the topic credit rating agencies. So I'll go to start quiz. So without wasting any time, let us see the first question. Question 1. Consider the below statements regarding credit rating agencies in India. So in this question, we are given 3 statements. We have to see which of them are correct. So statement 1. A credit rating agency can be registered as a company or a trust. So statement 1, it is incorrect. Why? Because as per credit rating regulations of 1999, so SEBI has made credit rating agencies regulations of 1999, and as per these regulations, a credit rating agency can be registered only as a company. The only form in which a credit rating agency can operate is a company form. So statement 1 is incorrect because it cannot be registered as a trust, right? Now statement 2, the minimum net worth requirement for a credit rating agency is rupees 25 crore. So this statement is right. So a credit rating agency must have a net worth of at least 25 crore to be registered as a credit rating agency, and also it is required to maintain this net worth at all times. So statement 2 is right. And statement 3, SEBI regulations 1999 cover rating of securities only. So this statement is again correct because rating can be given to different type of entities. So rating can be given to a company, rating can be given even to a country, but SEBI regulations, they cover rating of only securities. So statement 3 is right. So the question is asking us which of the above statements are incorrect. So you can see only statement 1, it is incorrect. So the correct option is option A, statement 1. Now next question 2, what is the minimum shareholding requirement for a promoter of a credit rating agency? So before discussing the minimum shareholding requirement, you must know who are the eligible promoters. So who can become a promoter of a credit rating agency? So as per the regulations, the eligible promoters are either a public financial institution or a scheduled commercial bank can be a promoter, or a foreign bank. Then number 4, a foreign credit rating agency, it can also become a promoter, and any company or body corporate having minimum net worth of at least 100 crore for the preceding 5 years. So any company or body corporate having a continuous minimum net worth of at least rupees 100 crores for preceding 5 years. So these are the eligible promoters. So this is very important. You need to know that who are eligible to become a promoter of a credit rating agency. So the regulations state that the minimum shareholding requirement for a promoter is 26%. So promoter needs to hold at least 26% shareholding of a credit rating agency. So the correct option is option D. Now next question 3, credit rating agencies in India are governed by SEBI regulations 1999. This I have told you. Consider the below statements. Now statement 1, a credit rating agency can withdraw the rating given by it to a security anytime. Now statement 1, it is incorrect. Why? Because a credit rating agency cannot withdraw the rating anytime. So here you need to understand one thing, that a credit rating agency enters into an agreement with a client. And who is the client? Client is the company who issues a security. So the issuer of security. So the agency rates the security issued by the client, right? So this credit rating agency, it cannot withdraw the rating given by it anytime. So as long as there are outstanding obligations on that security. So let's say the client has obtained rating on, let's say, a bond issued by it. So as long as there are outstanding obligations, so let's say there is an outstanding interest payment which is due. So there is an interest payment which is due on the part of the issuer company. So as long as there are outstanding obligation, up till then the agency cannot withdraw the rating. So only if there are no outstanding obligations, then only a credit rating agency can withdraw the rating, right? So statement one is incorrect, because an agency cannot withdraw the rating anytime. It has to ensure that there are no outstanding obligations. In statement two, a credit rating agency cannot hold 10% or more shareholding and or voting rights in any other credit rating agency. So this statement is right, because as per the regulations, one credit rating agency cannot hold 10% or more shareholding in another credit rating agency. So statement 2 is right. And statement 3, a credit rating agency cannot rate securities issued by it. So this is again correct, and this is very obvious, because how can you rate the securities issued by yourself only? So it will not be fair for an agency to rate its own securities, right? So statement 3 is also right. So the question is asking you which of the above statements are incorrect. So you can see only statement 1, it is incorrect. So the correct option is option D, only statement 1. Now next question 4. So before discussing this question, I would like to tell you that I have also discussed this topic of credit rating agencies on our Telegram group. So we regularly conduct quizzes and post questions on that group. Also, a lot of relevant information regarding various examinations is being shared. So do join our Telegram group and get the benefit. The link for the group is provided in the description section below. So question 4, which of the following is the first credit rating agency of India? So this is important, this you need to know, that the first credit rating agency of India is CRISIL. CRISIL is the first and the largest credit rating agency of India. All other credit rating agencies have been established afterwards. And in these options, you can see that option E, it is mentioned SEBI. So SEBI is not exactly a credit rating agency, rather it is a credit bureau. So there is a difference between a credit rating agency and a credit bureau. So option A, B, C, D, they all are credit rating agencies, but option E, SEBI, it is a credit bureau. So SEBI, it gives a score called CIBIL score to individuals. So whenever you go to take a loan from any bank, so the bank checks your CIBIL score. So the CIBIL score basically is your financial report card. So it talks about your credit history. So how many times you have taken loan and whether you have paid your loans on time or not. So that is your credit history. So you must know the full forms of these agencies. It is very important. CRISIL, CARE, ICRA, CIBIL. So you can get it easily from Google. Now moving on, next question, question 5. So friends, credit rating agency, they are an important intermediary and perform a very important role. Similarly, stock brokers, they also play a very important role as an intermediary in the stock market. So you can see the video on important questions on stock brokers by clicking on the link being shown at the top right corner of the screen. So question 5, which of the following credit rating agency was founded in 2005 by SEBI and other institutions exclusively for MSME sector? So in 2005, a credit rating agency was established by SEBI exclusively for MSME sector. MSME stands for micro, small and medium enterprises. So small scale companies basically. So this agency was founded in 2005. So the correct answer is option E, Smera Ratings. So Smera Ratings is a credit rating agency which is formed exclusively for small scale sector or MSME sector, and Smera stands for small and medium enterprise rating agency, right? So the correct option is option E, Smera. Now next question 6, how many credit rating agencies are registered with SEBI? So a lot of intermediaries are registered with SEBI, and I have told you in earlier video also that only registered intermediaries, they can operate in the stock market. Non-registered intermediaries, they are not allowed to operate, right? So the question is asking you how many credit rating agencies are registered with SEBI. So I will give you the answer by visiting the SEBI website. So here I will go to the SEBI website. So here go to this link, and if you go to the bottom of this page, so here you will be seeing a word written intermediaries at the bottom, right? So adjacent to statistics, there is a link for intermediaries. So just go to this link. So here you have to go to recognized intermediaries. So recognized intermediaries are those which have been registered with SEBI. So here you can see a list of all the intermediaries, different types of intermediaries registered with SEBI. So I will show you the registered credit rating agencies. So this serial number 9 credit rating agency, you can go to this link. This is updated on 18th August. So here you can see there are 7 credit rating agencies which are registered currently. So first is Acute Ratings, then Brickwork Ratings, then there is CARE, then after that CRISIL, then ICRA, the next is India Ratings and Research, which was earlier called Fitch Ratings India Private Limited, and the 7th one is Informatics Valuation and Ratings Private Limited. So these are the 7 credit rating agencies which are registered with SEBI. So the correct option is option E, 7. Now the last question. So before discussing this question, I would like to tell you that I have posted similar quizzes on other topics for your SEBI grade examination. So you can attempt those quizzes on our website and see your preparation level. So the link for the website is provided in the description section below. Now final question, question 7. Consider the below organizations. So here you are given names of 5 agencies or organizations. You have to identify which of these are not a credit rating agency of India. So I'm not going to tell you the answer to this question. So mention the answer to this question in the comment section below. Then afterwards I will post the right answer. So friends, if you have learned anything new from this video, then do subscribe to our channel by clicking on the link being shown at the top left corner of your screen. Also, if you want to see my previous video, then click on the link being shown at the top middle of the screen. And also you can subscribe to our course on SEBI by clicking on the link being shown at the top right corner of the screen. So we have made a comprehensive course, and you can take the benefit of videos, PDFs and mock tests, which will help you a lot in your SEBI grade A preparation. So stay tuned to our channel to get more notifications and updates. Have a nice day.